So we have this diagram, and we're told that we've got to fill it in such a way that any number between 1 and 21 can be made by either taking a single number or the sum of two adjacent numbers, three adjacent numbers, four adjacent numbers, or all five numbers. So one of the first things we can have a little think about is, well, how many ways are there to sum up 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5 adjacent numbers? Well, there's definitely 5 ways to just choose one number. There are 5 pairs of 2 adjacent numbers. Similarly, there are 5 triples, because you can choose any one of the 5 positions to start at. There are 5 sets of 4 adjacent numbers. You just choose one to leave out. And there's obviously one way that you add them all up. So we have 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 1, which is 21 possible different ways to add up a combination of these numbers. And so if we're trying to get all of the numbers between 1 and 21, this means that every number between 1 and 21 has to appear in exactly one way. So for example, we definitely can't have any repetitions here, because if I had a number here that was equal to a number somewhere else, then that would be 2 ways of making the same number. So what else can we get from this? Well, let's start by thinking about how we're going to make the number 2. Well, there's only really 2 ways to make the number 2. We can add 1 and 1, or we can just take the number 2 on its own. If we were adding 1 and 1, this would violate the thing we just talked about, where we said that no 2 numbers can be the same. So we're forced to have that 2 is made by just taking a single number. And so one of these 3 numbers, I've called these ones W and Y, one of these 3 numbers here must be equal to 2. Let's also think about how we're going to get 21. So since 21 is the biggest of our 21 numbers we're trying to make, the only way we're going to be able to get it is of the sum of all 5 numbers. So 21 is 1 plus 5 plus W plus X plus Y, which implies that W plus X plus Y is 15. So we've now got 2 bits of information at our disposal. We know that the sum of these 3 numbers is 15, and one of them is 2. So what are our possibilities? Let's ignore for a minute the order of these 3 numbers and just think about what values they could take. So we can have 2, 3, and 10, 2, 4, and 9, 2, 5, and 8, or 2, 6, and 7. And these are the only possibilities we have, because we're forced to take these numbers all distinct. So quite quickly, we can eliminate these 2 options. So clearly, this is not a valid option, because we'd have one of these 3 numbers being a 5, and we already have a 5 over here. We can also get rid of this one, because we know that 1 add 5 is 6, and so we've already made 6 in some way. And so having an extra number 6 here would mean that 2 of our sums are the same. So we've narrowed it down to 2 options. So I'm going to look for a minute at 2, 4, and 9. So 2 and 4 add up to 6, and so do 1 and 5. So if we put 2 and 4 next to each other, then we're going to have 2 ways to make 6. So this forces 2 and 4 to go in these positions. So 4 has to be either W or Y. Now if W is 4, let's put a 4 in here, then we've made 5 over here, but we've also made 5 as the sum of 1 and 4. That's bad. If we were to put 4 over here, then we've made 9 as the sum of 5 and 4, but 9 is also one of our other 2 remaining numbers. So again, that's bad. But these were our only possible positions for 4, because 2 and 4 can't go next to each other. So if 4 were in the middle, it would be forced to be next to 2. So all of the possible ways we could place 2, 4, and 9 in these circles fail. Which means that our triple WXY must be 2, 3, and 10 in some order. And now we just have to figure out what that order is. So clearly 2 can't go next to 1. Otherwise we'd have 1 and 2 over here, but also the 3. 2 and 3 also can't go next to each other, because if we had 2 and 3 in adjacent positions, we'd have a way to make 5, and we already have 5 over here. So if 2 can't go over here, and it also can't go next to 3, well then it can't go in this position here, else we'd have 3 in one of these positions, and it would be next to 2. So 2 is forced to go over here. And now we just need to fiddle around with the last few terms. We know that either we have 3 and 10, like this, in which case we have 3 plus 2 plus 5 equals 10. So this fails. So we must instead have that 3 goes here and 10 goes here. And I leave it as an exercise to check that you can get all 21 numbers this way. So the final answer is that x equals 10.